What does that say about the future of this region of the world?
That's what we're all asking right now. Mm-hmm. Short term, for at least our organization, that means that, you know, we will most likely cancel our trip in July. There might be peace, at least on a political level, by then. Hopefully within the next few weeks is what we're hoping. Mm-hmm. But that's not going to translate to the streets for, I'm guessing, a year. I think Kofi Annan has said at least a year it's going to take to work some of this out, because these are long-held discrepancies, tribe to tribe, that were never dealt with mm-hmm. upon independence. The other presidents never dealt with these things. Mm-hmm. So this is what's bubbling up right now. So it's going to be, you know, I hope to go back maybe in January, if not with a group, with myself, to see, just to make contact with family and with our orphanages, and to see, you know, where these kids are, where these people are. Mm-hmm. Long term, we're in it for the long term. It's family now. Mm-hmm. So whether that means we take travelers or we just try to go ourselves and make sure family is safe and maintain those ties, that's what we'll do, and support organizations that we know that are already there on the ground. Mm-hmm. That they'll be the ones doing the rebuilding. Mm-hmm. You know, we'll just bring people in. So,
explain to us briefly what So Far Kenya is.
Yeah, it's basically our mission statement. We're a hands-on, creative service opportunity, basically designed to educate, empower Africans and Americans. It's a two-way effort. We focus our, you know, service opportunity around this trip. But we also do, you know, have activities with Kenyans in Kansas City. We run the organization. It's Kenyans and Americans running this thing. So it's not the old colonial model of, you know, we're going to sweep in, do our thing for you because it makes us feel good. Mm-hmm. And then you don't have, your opinion doesn't matter, African, you know? So that's the heart of, mm-hmm. it's a collaborative effort mm-hmm. between Kenyans.
It's a team effort.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And so, if a person would like to contribute or do something to help this organization, how do they do that?
At this point, what we have to offer are the trips, but, you know, that's obviously going to be canceled. We just had someone sign up last week to go. Mm-hmm. You know, either they have no idea what's going on there right now, or they want to help. You know, they want to go to help mm-hmm. do the rebuilding. The only other way to really help right now is if they were to give us a cash donation. We have a PayPal account on our blog and on our website. They're linked to each other. We have a P.O. box, you can send a check, and it sounds difficult to just ask for cash right now, mm-hmm. but that is what they need, and we trust our family and our people to get that kind of aid directly to the people that need it. Mm-hmm. Government aid does not work. Mm-hmm. It just goes government to government. The people mm-hmm. never see it. And that money right now is going towards Julius, and because he's not just with his family. You know, we could get in trouble with the IRS if it was just supporting our family, but uh-huh. he's checking on our orphanages. He's making sure that our service sites uh-huh. are operational, and if uh-huh. not, he's giving us those reports. So, uh-huh. You know, he's the guy on the ground for us right now.
Uh-huh. Are these HIV or orphanages?
Some of them, yeah. Uh-huh. I would say at least maybe 10% of the kids and women that we work with are HIV positive. Many of them aren't even tested because the test is expensive and there's still a stigma. They don't mm-hmm. want to know. They don't want to know.
And these are a large percentage of the children are left as orphans because of HIV.
Yes, mm-hmm. or because of just poverty in general. It's the fifth kid mm-hmm. and the mother cannot have feed another mouth.
Right.
So they just dump them outside the gate.
Now,
kind of thing.
We've had people from Joplin go to Kenya
yes.
to help with this organization.
Yeah. We've had two faculty members of Missouri Southern last summer, Jim Jackson in the biology department and Brenda Jackson in the theater department. I've just built a relationship with them for a couple years, and they're well traveled. I had always wanted to go to a part of Africa, but didn't just want to go on safari. They wanted to actually go serve and go with someone that they knew. This next summer we had scheduled to go a nursing student at Missouri Southern and a full-blown RN who works in the field. I'm not sure where she is exactly. They know each other from their programs, and they were slated to go.
Mm-hmm.
And they've been, you know, kind of dreaming about this for 2 years, basically. So I've met with them, and but like I said, we'll have a final decision in 2 weeks mm-hmm. on whether we're going to go. And we just see it as postponing. You know, mm-hmm. I mean, if someone's taken 5 years to decide to do this trip one more year, mm-hmm. it's not, you know, not going to make or break it. So that's, yeah, so we're involved.
I can imagine you in your classroom teaching art appreciation classes. Mm. How can you not think about what's going on there while you're doing that? I mean, how can you concentrate?
It's impossible. When I found out last week, I actually came and taught a class that next morning at 10 o'clock before I got on the road to Kansas City to stay with my sister. And it was an art education class. So these are all people that'll be teaching art in the schools. And I had a decision to make. I'm like, I can talk about this or I can just go on with my day and just get out of here. Because I'm not, you know, an emotions on your sleeves person, so I could have hit it, mm-hmm. you know. But I decided, no, this is a teachable moment. They need to know about this. I told them the situation, and I said, you're going to be teachers in the classroom. How can you bring the world to your classroom? How can you get these Southwest Missouri kids who maybe never even crossed state lines, you know, and their families never even crossed state lines, to care about another nation? And we talked about that, and they could see, you know, my connections with it, my family connections with it. They've been keeping up on the blog with, you know, Julius and his travels and what he's doing. They're teachers, they're compassionate people anyway, you know. Mm-hmm. So I just used it in my classes. I'm letting them know what's going on. Like, this school has an international mission, mm-hmm. and we need to live it out. Mm-hmm. Not just talk about going to Europe for a couple weeks and seeing the Louvre, you know. I mean, this is it, you know, and the connections that professors have mm-hmm. and faculty, not just international students coming here or trips, but how are we engaged as professors with the world, and mm-hmm. our students need to see that.
What was the reaction to your students?
Disbelief, surprise. They had heard it on NPR in the morning. They had seen it on as the top story on Yahoo, mm-hmm. you know, which surprised me as well. I mean, uh-huh. I didn't realize, I mean, I knew he was in Parliament, my brother-in-law, but I didn't know this was going to be so far-reaching. And by name, you know, his name's all over the place, not just that Parliament member, mm-hmm. you know, by name. So I could watch in their faces, they're trying to wrap their heads around it too. Mm-hmm. And if I'm having a difficult time and I've been there, mm-hmm. you know, I really can't imagine. You know, if they haven't been out of the four state area, you know, their stereotypes of what Kenyans are, you know, what orphans are, what Parliament means, you know, so there's a lot I could dissect with them and unpack with them on that. But I just basically let them know, follow the blog, be informed. You're at a university now, you have no excuse for ignorance. You've chosen to be educated, and this is part of your education. So. They, you know, they're not just stocking shelves at Walmart, mm-hmm. and they're advancing their education. So I don't mince words, and I try to challenge them, and this is part of that. It fits. So,
Josie, thanks for your time today
in
this interview. I hope we've informed our readers a little bit about the situation there.
Me too.
That they might not have been able to appreciate until now. And thank you again for your time.
Thank you.